Hey guys and girls, welcome back to another edition of Spintires. Now I need to say something straight off the bat before we go any further. No, you cannot have this mod. And there's a reason why. I didn't create it, and I edited it to suit me. Now, I want to keep a good reputation with all the modders and creators on the Steam community forums, as well as those on, you know, Uvi and Spintires.nl. And I don't want to be known as a guy who basically gets other people's mods, changes them, then re-uploads them and claims them as their own. There is a story behind this one, and I'm going to give it to you right now, so you guys know full up I'm going to be straight and level with you. Yes, I'm still going to be reviewing other people's mods on my channel. I am not going to be editing anybody's mods apart from this one. Now there's a reason why, and here we go. For ages, I don't know how long, I've been waiting for someone to put an Audi Q7 onto the Steam Community Workshop. Now, a couple of days ago, one appeared. The only problem I had with that mod was, despite the very best efforts of the guy who uploaded it, or the person who uploaded it, it was still not to the performance level that I was expecting. Now, the original mod that this one is based on was a black Audi Q7 with the factory wheels, and it had a car ride height like an SUV would. Now, the guy who uploaded it did a really good job of making the Audi Q7. I'm not going to mock him for that. It was good. However, I love Audi so much, I wanted this Audi Q7 to be my new map exploration vehicle. Sorry for the burp. Now, I basically learned how to edit the XML file behind this, and no, I'm not going to be editing anyone else's trucks or anything like that, but I needed to make this one unique to me. So, what did I change from the original? The original mod had the car ride height, it had very dull headlights, it only had one winch point at the front, one winch point at the back. The suspension was more set up for high speed, not for trails. It only had 90 litres of onboard fuel, and it only had damage points of about 800, I think. So, what have I changed? Pretty much everything. For one, it's no longer black, I've changed it to an Audi type blue, which I think brings out a bit more details on the body, so I like that. The original headlights were dull, I've made them bright. I've given it a lift kit, so it's a lot higher off the ground than what it was, so it's now a little bit more off-road capable. I've given it a custom set of rims and tires, which I did have permission to do. I have changed the suspension, I have changed how this vehicle runs. Basically, I've changed the engine output because originally it was way too powerful. So I've cut the engine output in half. I have basically changed the gearbox, so the gearbox is now more trail friendly. I have added an additional winch point front and rear because if this is going to be my new trail exploration vehicle, I needed it to be more capable than what the original was. The original had really nice engine sounds, but they just weren't tough enough for me, so I've edited the engine sounds to make this sound great. The original mod had the camera mounted up here on the roof. I wanted crawler cam, so I could see where the wheels were going when I do get into some hard stuff. Now remember, this is an SUV. It does not have the same capabilities as a live axle lifted truck. But I've changed the way it performs, I've changed the way it looks. I've upped the fuel. Now, if I had done this to the original mod, I would be stuck here and need to get pulled out. So, I've edited the tire grip. So now, I can get myself out of trouble. So, even though I'm not 100% happy with the suspension, I've lifted it up as high as I can go because this is an SUV. There are no axles underneath it. I've also changed the air intake level. If I had done that with the original model, by now the engine would be taking on damage. Okay, as I said, I've also added an additional winch point front and rear. I've given myself crawler cam so I can see exactly where I am. Let me back it up and give you a better example. So now I can see exactly where those wheels are. Okay, the steering angle has been increased, so from being about 27 degrees or something like that, it's now 45. So it now steers on the trails as good as I can get it, without making it look ridiculous. But anyway, guys, as I said, I don't want to step on anyone's toes. I want to still be able to review mods for other creators. But I needed to make this Audi Q7 my own. Alrighty, guys, so basically that's the story behind this. I created it to suit me. I won't be sharing it with anyone because I do not want to get a bad reputation as a person who edits trucks and then re-uploads them to the community claiming them that they are their own. Alrighty, guys, anyway, you will be seeing this vehicle in up and coming videos because it is going to be one of my new map explorers. Unless the map is too hard, then I will be using someone else's vehicle. Alrighty, guys, until next time, bye for now.